ladies and gentlemen, CAW fans worldwide, we are live here tonight from Buffalo, New York, as we continue on the road to our next mega event, Unbound. As tonight, we welcome you to the 20th episode of the Universal Championship Wrestling League. Hello, everyone. This is V-Pac here once again as we are set for another exciting night of action here at the Universal Championship Wrestling League, as we are now just only two episodes away, counting this one, of course, to our next mega event, Unbound, as we are set for an exciting night of action here at... Well, ladies and gentlemen, I was just about to go over the card for tonight's show, and it looks like we're being interrupted by Mad Max. Well, of course, Mad Max did state on the last episode that he planned on coming out here tonight to call out William Wallace, who he viciously assaulted back on episode 17. And we have not seen Wallace since. Of course, there's been a lot of speculation as to whether or not even William Wallace is still a part of the UCWL roster after he turned up in SCAW recently. But in any case, it looks like, yeah, Mad Max is calling for a microphone, and it looks like we're going to be hearing from the Road Warrior right now. Oh, how dare this man insult SCAW, one of the longest running virtual wrestling promotions on YouTube. Oh, wait a minute! Wait just a minute here! That is the music of William Wallace! And there he is! We have not seen William Wallace since episode 17, when he got eliminated from the Elimination Chase. And then he was viciously... That was, of course, due to Mad Max assaulting him. Oh, here he comes! And William Wallace storming the ring and going right after Mad Max! William Wallace is back! And he is taking the fight to the Road Warrior! William Wallace, now look at this! Beating the living snot out of Mad Max! And there you see the referee just letting these two fight. They're not even scheduled to compete here tonight. And these two men are beating the hell out of each other. Mad Max looks like his... Mad Max had regained control momentarily, but William Wallace is beating the hell out of... He's beating the hell out of him now! And we may need security out here to break these two up. We'll be right back. Well, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to UCWL episode 20. And moments ago, this happened. We saw the return of William Wallace after Mad Max came out at the start of the show and called him out. And these two got into a pure six brawl inside the ring. But then, ladies and gentlemen, during the commercial break, the fighting continued. And then General Manager Phil Coulson would come out and drop this bombshell. Well, ladies and gentlemen, talk about the meeting card subject to change. You never know what's going to happen here in UCWL. Our main event originally advertised was supposed to be a tag team match, but now it's been turned into a six-man tag team match, as tonight, Mad Max finds himself teaming with both the wielder of the Death Note, Light Yagami, and one of the men who will challenge for the UCWL Championship at Unbound, Nathan Explosion, as they will now take on the team consisting of William Wallace, Keith Abicary, and the UCWL champion, the Green Arrow, in our main event later tonight. Also tonight, ladies and gentlemen, we'll have a small preview of the number one contenders match for the UCWL Tag Team Championships at Unbound, as tonight, Captain Britain of MI13 will go one-on-one with Bebop. Which team will get the edge heading into Unbound? We'll find out later tonight. And let's not also forget, tonight is match number 6 in the Elimination Chase. As tonight, the final three competitors, Chef Gordon Ramsay, Kyo Kusanagi, and Jack, face off in a triple threat match. Only two of these men will head to the final match on our final episode before Unbound, and be one step closer to challenging for the Cyberspace Championship at Unbound. And speaking of the Cyberspace Champion, he is kicking us off here tonight on episode 20 as Monkey D. Luffy is in non-title action against Android 13 to start us off. Let's head up to Shao Curtis for the introductions to our opening contest.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is your opening contest for this evening. It is a non-title match, and is set for one fall. Introducing first, from the Red Ribbon Army, Android 13.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're kicking things off here with this non-title match, as here comes Android 13 to the ring. Android 13 was originally part of the Elimination Chase. In fact, I believe he was one of the first two individuals that was actually eliminated in the Elimination Chase. So, this he could be looking at this match here as an opportunity to put himself back in the Cyberspace Championship hunt if he were to somehow manage to pick up the victory here tonight against the reigning champion. But that, ladies and gentlemen, is definitely easier said than done, which I'm pretty sure Android 13 is going to find out in just a few moments.
Cyberspace Champion, Monkey D. Luffy.
And there he is, ladies and gentlemen. the cyberspace champion Monkey D. Luffy, who as of this reporting will be participating in that gauntlet match on the Impulse brand over an Anime Championship Wrestling to determine if he'll get a shot, a future shot at the Impulse title. Let's hope he's not looking towards that match right now or his impending Cyberspace Championship title defense at Unbound and his focus here tonight on his match against Android 13. And there's the bell, ladies and gentlemen, and this match is kicking things off here on our 20th episode of UCWL. Notice that Luffy now with the side headlock into the takedown on Android 13. It looks, notice Luffy now with Android 13. Oh, look at that, brainbuster right on top of Android 13's head. Well, it's Android 13 right back up. Hits the uppercut. And he follows it up with a sidewalk slam. Of course, like I mentioned earlier, Android 13 could be using this matchup. If he were to pick up a victory here tonight over Luffy, he could catapult himself back into the Cyberspace Championship title hunt. Well, this though, Luffy fights back, gets up with a shoulder block. And now Luffy, what's this? Measuring Android 13 with a huge knee lift into a neck breaker. I think the Miz used to do that move. Oh wait, Luffy's on the top rope! Huge diving headbutt into the shoulder of Android 13. And look, oh look at this! Unique cover there by Monkey D. Luffy, but only gets a one count. Android 13 retakes control of this matchup now. And now Android 13 sending Luffy into the corner. Follows it up with a released German suplex. And now Luffy, look at this, fighting back with the uppercut. And look at this, Monkey D. Luffy. Oh, what is this? Got Android 13 cradled up. Oh, what a move. Like a bridging power bomb of some kind. Here's the cover. And again, only a one count. I can tell you right now, ladies and gentlemen, I'm pretty sure the final three participants in the elimination chase are watching this matchup very closely to see what the Cyberspace Champion brings to the table. As Bucky T. Luffy now sending Android 13 to the corner. Oh, Android 13 fights out of it though. Now Android 13 with an elbow drop. Now look at this. Android 13 wrenching on the neck of the Cyberspace Champion. As down goes Luffy. The knee lift, and there's the axe kick. We've seen him do that move in the past plenty of times. But look at this, instead of continuing his focus on Luffy, he's taunting the fans. I'm not sure if it's a smart move or not. And now, all of this though, Luffy back to his feet after that shot to the gut there. He went for a tilt-a-whirl into a small package, but couldn't hang on to him. Android 13, though, counters with an arm drag, and then just chucks Luffy down by his head. Look at this now. Arm drag takeover there by 13. And now, look at this. Cravat suplex there. A cravat, yeah, nice cravat suplex there from Android 13. And now Luffy finds himself on the ring apron. Now look at this, Android 13 seems to be talking trash. I'm not sure if that's a smart move to Luffy, and that's exactly why And look at that! Monkey D. Luffy just coming right back in with that tornado DDT. And now, what's Luffy got planned here? Oh, look at this line. That's what he's got planned. The LOL. 2-0, only a two count. Monkey D. Luffy hitting the LOL onto Android 13. That seems only pissed off. That seems only pissed him off even more. Now look at this. Android 13 hits the jawbreaker. Luffy blocks the shot though. Now look at this. Luffy over the shoulder into a flapjack of some kind. As you see this capacity crowd really getting into this matchup. And now look at this. Luffy with a second one. Two in a row by the cyberspace champion on Android 13. Android 13 back up. Loving blows there by the by Android 13. Into an overhead belly-to-belly suplex. And now it's Android 13 in control here. The raging redneck Android in control of this matchup. Oh, that's a nice counter there by Luffy. On that headbutt there from Monkey D. Luffy as well. All right, there's a unique cover again. Two. And only a two count. And Android 13 clobbers him with a clothesline. Android 13 does not want to be defeated here tonight. He knows a big victory here could put him back in the Cyberspace Championship title hunt. And look at that running drop kick. Right to the back of Monkey D. Luffy. Look at this Luffy though with the arm drag. Headbutts him into the ropes. Now Monkey D. Luffy with a third version of that move. And look at this kick in the midsection there by Android 13. Follows it up with an uppercut. Oh, that's now Luffy knocks him over the top rope, but Android 13 lands on the ring apron, but gets knocked down to the arena floor below. And now look at this, Luffy. Luffy's going upstairs. Luffy's on the top rope. What's he got planned here? Oh, God! A somersault plancha. And we're going to take a look at that one more time. Take a look at this somersault plancha to the outside, right onto Android 13. How impressive was that? As now we're back to the action out here. Oh, look at this though. Oh, Android 13 with a Michinoku driver on the arena floor. And now sending Luffy back into the ring. Follows it up with that big boot to the side of the head. And now, Android 13 hits him with the uppercut. Hello, this though. Luffy fighting back. Look at these shots and out. Oh, here we go again. Another LOL. Except this time, Luffy knew he was too close to the ropes and decided not to go for the cover. Irish whips him into the ropes. Does so again. Oh, here's that cover again. Trying to go for that cover, but this time, again, Android 13 too close to the ropes. And now Monkey D. Luffy. Another Irish whip. And oh, God! This time he got a pop-up gum-gum bullet right to the face of Android 13, and this one's over. And just like that, ladies and gentlemen, Monkey D. Luffy with the victory over Android 13 as we take a look at some of the action that took place throughout this matchup. How about this move right here from Luffy? A bridging powerbomb of some kind. Android 13, though, would fight back, hit him with that standing axe kick. Of course, there's that cravat suplex earlier from Android 13. How about this move right here? Tornado DDT and a somersault block of the floor as the fight continued all over the place. It eventually ended here with that pop-up gum gum bullet that allowed Luffy to get the victory.
Here is your winner, the UCWL Cyberspace Champion, Monkey D. Luffy.
And Monkey D. Luffy is victorious here tonight, sending a very loud and clear message that he's ready to defend his title at Unbound. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back.
Oh no, oh no, oh no. Yo, 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 oh no, you didn't. Sucker tried to play me, but you never paid me, never. Oh no, you didn't. Payback is a coming, you will be running forever. Oh no, you didn't. Until I get my vengeance, I will never end this mayhem. Oh no, you didn't. I'm a mercenary, you ain't got a prayer, you owe me. Oh no, you didn't. 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 Didn't you? Oh no, you didn't pay me what you owe me. So now it's over for you. First you try to trap me, then you bust a cap in my ass. Oh no, you didn't. Such humiliation will bring annihilation at last. Oh no, you didn't. It will be delicious when I get vicious tomorrow. Oh no, you didn't. There's no second chances, you will do the dance of sorrow.
We
Well, it looks like Light Yagami is not short on confidence, not only when it comes to his upcoming match with Keith Abbey at Unbound, but also our main event later tonight. And speaking of main events, we want to take you back right now to the main event of our last episode, which saw Nathan Explosion choose Light Yagami to be his tag team partner to face off against both the UCWL champion, the Green Arrow, and the other challenger for that title at Unbound, Yuri Boyka. Following the conclusion of that match, both Nathan Explosion and Yuri Boyka would get into a brawl where Nathan Explosion would hit Boyka with the hammer, a vicious forearm strike that he normally hits to the back of an opponent's head, but this time would connect right into Boyka's face, followed by our show going off the air. However, what the cameras did not show was that the forearm strike legitimately knocked out Yuri Boyka for 3.5 minutes. Luckily though, Boyka was able to come to, and after a little bit of help from our staff, was able to leave on his own 2 feet. However, by order of General Manager Phil Coulson, Boyka has checked into the Hershey Medical Center back in Hershey Park, Pennsylvania, for observation to make sure he doesn't have any permanent brain damage or any other form of head trauma. However, ladies and gentlemen, we can also tell you this, that Yuri Boyka is still scheduled to compete in the main event of Unbound, and we hope to have a more updated report on the status of Yuri Boyka either later tonight or by episode 21. With that said, let's head back up to Shao Curtis for the introductions to our next match.
Ladies and gentlemen, this next contest is set for one fall. Introducing first, being coming to the ring by Union Jack, from Maldoon, Essex, England, he is one half of MI-13, Captain Britain!
And ladies and gentlemen, we are getting set for this, what I like to call a small preview of one of the matches that's going to take place at Unbound, as here comes one half of MI-13, Captain Britain, alongside his tag team partner Union Jack to the ring. And needless to say, Captain Britain is definitely going to have his hands full in this matchup here tonight, here on episode 20, as we await his opponent.
And his opponent, being coming to the ring by Rocksteady and Karai, from New York City,
and just like Captain Britain, ladies and gentlemen, Bebop is not coming to the ring alone. Of course, there you see Rocksteady, his longtime tag team partner, alongside him, and joining them at ringside for the first time is Karai, who we have not seen in a little while, mainly because I finally figured out how to use managers in this game. But in any case, here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Bebop set to go one-on-one with Captain Britain right here on episode 20. And there's the bell, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, God! And right off the bat, Bebop wasting no time launching Captain Britain in the air and hitting him with an uppercut. I mean, we normally see Captain Britain do something similar like that. Look at this now. Britain, though, fighting back here against Bebop. Well, as I mentioned before, MI-13 will clash with Rocksteady and Bebop at Unbound. Of course, that'll determine who will be next in line for a shot at the UCWL Tag Team titles. As there you see Captain Britain with a massive hip toss onto Bebop. Of course, the Tag Team Champions right now are the Big Bang Theory. Of course, they will be defending those titles as well at Unbound against Final Fight, Cody and Guy. So you could say that both these matches are intertwined somehow. In any case, now there you see Union Jack trying to root on his tag team partner as Bebop with a massive suplex onto Captain Britain. I mean, I have to admit, Rocksteady and Bebop have definitely shown they're not just two hulking brutes. And, oh, look at that! They have impressive agility as well, but so does Captain Britain. I mean, Captain Britain, of course, a mixture of speed, strength, and agility. Now look at this. Britain now on the top rope. Measuring Bebop. What's he got planned here? Massive clothesline off the top rope there by Captain Britain. Captain Britain now. What's he got planned here? Oh, huge knee right to the face of Bebop. Look at now Bebop with the counter. As there's Rocksteady and Karai. Both rooting Bebop on. Oh, and look at this. Bebop's on the second rope. I don't know if that's a smart move. Taunting like that. Oh, exactly. That would have crushed Captain Britain. But luckily, Britain was able to move out of the way, but he wasn't been able to avoid that arm trap. Now look at this. Bebop wrapping those massive legs around the throat of Captain Britain, followed that elbow to the top of his head. Oh, what a clothesline. What a clothesline there by Bebop. Look, that's now Captain Britain, though, fighting back. I think that clothesline might have done a lot more damage to Captain Britain than he thought he did. Britain now on the ropes, sending Bebop. And Britain looks a little bit dazed. And, oh, God! If he wasn't dazed after that clothesline, he's definitely dazed after that. That snapping the neck, almost a neckbreaker style, off the top rope. And now what's Bebop doing? And Bebop with a massive splash. Here's the cover. Two. And this one's over. And just like that, ladies and gentlemen, Bebop picks up the victory. Of course, that clothesline that literally knocked the wind out of Captain Britain, followed up by that splash.
Here is your winner, Bebop.
And Bebop gains the advantage for his team heading into the tag team match at Unbound. Ladies and gentlemen, don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
Told me anything anymore.
Looks like Daisy Johnson is back and wants to get her hands on both Bo Dennis and Faith Connors. Let's hope she can find a partner willing to tag with her for Unbound. And speaking of Unbound and the UCWL Women's Division, on our last episode, Quiet issued a challenge to Bindi Irwin for a rematch from their match in the Queens of Wrestling Tournament qualifiers. And it looks like her and Code Talker are at it again. Earlier today, they had this to say to Bindi Irwin and their potential matchup at Unbound. Let's have a look. Well, if I know Bindi Irwin like I think I do, she will answer this challenge laid down to her by Quiet and Code Talker. Well, ladies and gentlemen, don't go anywhere. When we come back, it's match number 6 in the Elimination Chase as Chef Gordon Ramsay, Kyo Kusanagi, and Jack face off in a triple threat match. Which two superstars will be one step closer to challenging for the Cyberspace Championship at Unbound? We'll find out next when UCWL returns.
Thank you.
Contest is the next match in the Elimination Chase to determine a number one contender for the UCWL Cyberspace Championship at Unbound, and it is a triple threat match that is set for one fall.
Welcome back to the 20th episode of UCWL, ladies and gentlemen, as there you see Chef Gordon Ramsay has entered the ring as we are getting set for match number 6 in the Elimination Chase. We started out with 8 competitors, we're now down to 3, and as of tonight we'll be down to the final 2. Could Chef Gordon Ramsay be one of them? We're going to find out momentarily as we await the second entry into this match.
Participant number 2, from Tokyo, Japan, Kyo.
And listen to this ovation for the head of the Kusanagi clan as Kyo Kusanagi makes his way to the ring. He's only 2 victories away, or needless to say, 2 matches away from becoming the number one contender of the Cyberspace Championship. Standing in his way, though, are 2 very eager opponents, just as eager as he is to challenge for the Cyberspace Championship at Unbound. We'll see how well he does in this matchup here tonight.
Introducing the final participant, from Haven City, Jack!
And And here comes the third and final participant in this triple threat match here tonight. It is Jack, who of course on our last episode in the Fatal 4-Way match was able to win that match and eliminate Ragnar Lothbrok from the elimination chase. Of course, immediately afterwards, Ragnar Lothbrok was viciously assaulted in the back by Skeletor. We'll get more information on that situation as it develops. Right now, ladies and gentlemen, we are down to three men. Two of them are already in the ring, and Jack is on his way to the ring right now. Can Jack pull off another victory again here tonight and be one step closer to advancing to the Cyberspace Championship match at Unbound? We're going to find out in mere moments. And there's the bell, ladies and gentlemen. This triple threat match is underway. As look at this, Jack immediately goes after Kyo Kusanagi with an electric chair drop. Like I said, only two of these men are going to advance to the finale. That'll be on our next episode. And look at this, Jack escaping the suplex attempt there from Kyo and then chop blocking him. Now look at that, Jack with an impaler DDT there. Like I said, this match is every man for himself, but so far, Jack has been dominating this triple threat match. Taking out both Kyo Kusanagi and Chef Gordon Ramsay. Though right now, Ramsay seems to be just lying in wait, trying to pick his spot as Jack and Kyo go one-on-one with each other. And Kyo makes him pay for it with that jumping tornado DDT. And now it's Kyo in control. Release Tiger Suplex. And he follows it up with a running dropkick to the side of Jack's head. And now Kyo going up to the top rope. He could be measuring Jack here. Wait, Gordon Ramsay's back in the ring. Oh, look at that. And Kyo decides to go after Ramsay instead, hitting him with that cross body block. And there's that half suplex there from Kyo, as now Jack finds himself on the outside of the ring. Oh, look at that! Kyo Kusanagi countering that swinging neck breaker into one of his own! But only gets a two count after the pin. Off the ropes goes Kyo. Running senton connects. Now look at this though. Jack with that edge-o-matic takes out Kyo. And now look at this, go over the cover on Ramsay. Only a one count though. Of course, this is a triple threat match. First pinfall or submission gets the win. And whoever wins this match and the individual that does not get pinned, we'll head into the finale next on our next episode. As there you see Gordon Ramsay with the F word onto Jack. Oh, look at this. Ride to Hell's Kitchen. Gordon Ramsay with the Rise to Hell's Kitchen. Is this the end for Kyo? And no, it's not. Kyo Kusanagi kicking out of the Ride to Hell's Kitchen. Oh, look at this. What's Jack doing here? Jack! Oh, God! What a move that was! One, two, Jack with a Hurricane Rana off the top rope on a Gordon Ramsay. And Ramsay landed on top of Jack with that senton. Now look at this. Jack now. What is... Oh, we've seen him do this before. The Exploder in the corner. And now, but look at this, though. Gordon Ramsay trying to sneak in. Oh, look at this, Jack. Oh, I thought he was going for the Eco Maker. Instead, he was going for a Gut Buster instead. But now he may be going for the Eco Maker. Oh, wait, no, he's not. Kyo's back up. Kyo Kusanagi now placing Jack on the top rope. Oh, look at that. How quick was Jack there? Jack jumped over Gordon Ramsay to hit that flying back elbow on a Kyo Kusanagi. As Kyo's down, Gordon Ramsay's back in control. Another F-word. Gordon Ramsay, though, seems to be a little dazed. As he's now going to work on Jack. Oh, here we go again. Another ride to Hell's Kitchen. The ride to Hell's Kitchen on the Jack. Here's the cover. Although this now, Kyo quickly breaks it up. Now Kyo Kusanagi. Elbow to the back of the head there. Now sending Ramsay into the corner. And then Gordon Ramsay shoulder first into the ring post. Kyo Kusanagi. What's this? Oh, look at that. Leaping over the top rope with that leg drop. And now look at this. Oh, Jack. Jack tried sending Kyo into the corner. Kyo catching him with that power slam, though. Here's the cover. One. And no, only a one count. And Jack misses the drop kick. Oh, wait, look at this. Jack! Oh, no! It looked like it was going to go for the Blue Eco Bomb. I mean, the... Now, here's the cover from Kyo. Two, and no, Gordon Ramsay breaks it up. Gordon Ramsay now. What's this? Hangman's Neckbreaker onto Kyo Kusanagi. Here's the cover. And this time Jack breaks it up. Look at this. Float over. And look at that now. Jack counters the Neckbreaker into one of his own. Here's the cover. Two. And no. Jack just getting a two count. Which one of these two men is going to advance to the finale on episode 21? Here's the cover by Jack. Is Gordon Ramsay out of the elimination chase? No, he's not. Alice Ramsay fighting to his feet here. Oh, look at... Oh, what a move that was by Kyo. Looks like a roll of dice. And now it's down to Kyo and Jack in the ring. Kyo blocks that Ace Crusher attempt there. Oh, it's now Kyo with a kick to the face and a clothesline to the back of Jack's head. And now Kyo sending Jack into the corner. Oh, what is this? Oh, how impressive was that? Second rope moonsault there by Kyo Kusanagi. Jack, though, back up. Now, oh, look at this. Double team neckbreaker. Momentary alliance there by Kyo Kusanagi and Gordon Ramsay. Now, Ramsay avoids the back suplex. And hits a regular suplex. Floats over into the cover. Two and no. And look at this. This time Gordon Ramsay actually connects with the swinging neck breaker. After having it countered twice during this matchup. Now here's the cover. Two and no. Again, Kyo Kusanagi kicks out at two. Now Jack is back in. Jack, backdrop suplex onto Kyo. Oh, wait a minute. Are we going to see it here? Jack! There it is! the Eco Maker. The Eco Maker on a Gordon Ramsay. And no! Gordon Ramsay just kicks out at two. And now Ramsay finds himself back in control with that judo hip throw. Oh, look at this. Boot is blocked. Heel kick to the face there by Jack. This has been a hell of a triple threat match right now between these three men. Oh, wait, look at this. Jack! Jack's in a lot of trouble here. Look at this! Kyo Kusanagi! I believe this... The Euro 108 SON, maybe. German suplex onto Gordon Ramsay. And now Kyo goes with a cover on Jack. Two. And he got him. Jesus, what a triple threat match this was. And ladies and gentlemen, that means in the end, Jack has been eliminated from the elimination chase. What a triple threat match this was, though. You see Gordon Ramsay with the first of, I think, two F-words, and he hits the ride to Hell's Kitchen onto Kyo Kusanagi. But it only gets a two count there. But it was after this right here. Kyo hit the Earl 108 SON onto Jack, followed by that German suplex to Ramsay. And that's what got him the three count.
Here is your winner, Kyo Kusanagi.
What a victory this was for Kyo Kusanagi. And now, ladies and gentlemen, there is only one match left in the elimination chase. And wait a minute, oh, look at this, Ramsay's back up! And that's right, ladies and gentlemen. You're looking at the two men left standing in the elimination chase. Only one of them is going to challenge Monkey D. Luffy for the Cyberspace Championship at Unbound. We'll be right back.
Era of wonder. Ladies and gentlemen, we are live for the Royal Rumble.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to UCWL episode 20. And if you're just joining us, here's what you just missed. We had our sixth match in the elimination chase that saw Chef Gordon Ramsay, Kyo Kusanagi, and Jack face off against each other in a triple threat match. And in the end, it was Kyo Kusanagi who would get the pinfall and the victory by pinning Jack. And thus, Jack is now out of the elimination chase. It was then followed down by this intense stare down between the final two competitors in the elimination chase, Kyo Kusanagi and Chef Gordon Ramsay. And so, ladies and gentlemen, we started out with eight superstars. And now we have reached the final two in the elimination chase. And with that, that means we are just one episode away from UCWL's next mega event, Unbound, live from Montreal, Quebec, Canada. And the card is starting to look jam-packed as we take a rundown of the Unbound card so far. As we just mentioned, Monkey D. Luffy will defend the UCWL Cyberspace Championship at Unbound against the winner of the Elimination Chase. It has come down to Chef Gordon Ramsay and Kyo Kusanagi. Regardless of who wins the chase, Luffy is going to have one tough challenge ahead of him come Unbound. In a match that was made by General Manager Phil Coulson earlier in the week, we will see the heated grudge match as Light Yagami faces off against Keith Abicary one-on-one. This whole thing started when Light Yagami made his return at Keith Abicary's expense back at Cold Day in Hell, and these two have been at each other's throats ever since. Will Keith Abicary get payback on the wielder of the Death Note, or will Yagami prove what he said about Abicary to be true? We'll see who comes out on top in Montreal. The UCWL Cruiser X Division Championship will be on the line in Unbound as well, as champion Yaiba Kamikaze takes on the only individual to ever pin him so far, Hollywood Adonis Creed. Yaiba has been completely ruthless ever since becoming champion, but Adonis has been more focused than ever to take that title off of the Cybernetic Ninja. Will Yaiba make a first successful title defense of the Cruiser X Division Championship at Unbound, or will the son of Apollo Creed be leading Montreal the new champion? The number one contender spot for the UCWL Tag Team Championship will be up for grabs at Unbound as well, as MI-13, Captain Britain, and Union Jack face off against the ginormous mutant tandem of Rocksteady and Bebop. Earlier tonight, we saw Bebop victorious over Captain Britain, so right now, Rocksteady and Bebop have all the momentum heading into this match. Will they use that momentum to come out on top at Unbound? Or will MI-13 bounce back from this setback and leave Montreal the new number one contenders? And speaking of the UCWL Tag Team Championships, They will be on the line at Unbound as well when the Big Bang Theory, Leonard Hofstadter, and Sheldon Cooper defend those titles against Final Fight, Cody, and Guy in a rematch from the finals of the Tag Team Gauntlet match from Cold Day in Hell. Can the saviors of Metro City make up for their loss in the Gauntlet match and take those titles off the champs? Or will the Big Bang Theory prove their naysayers wrong and show their win was not a fluke? We'll find out when these two teams clash in Montreal. And that brings us to the main event. The UCWL Championship will be on the line as the champion, the Green Arrow, defends his title against the two men who have been after him and his title for months, Nathan Explosion and Yuri Boyka. Despite Boyka's recent medical condition, he is still scheduled to compete in the main event. Can the most complete fighter in the world come out as the new UCWL champion? Or perhaps it may be Nathan Explosion who comes out on top? Or will the Emerald Archer find a way to defeat both of his opponents and retain his title? We'll find out all this and more at Unbound, live from Montreal, Quebec, Canada, in just a few weeks' time. But ladies and gentlemen, the road trip is not over yet. We have one last pit stop to make on the road to Unbound, and that pit stop is episode 21. And on that episode, we will see the finale of the Elimination Chase as Chef Gordon Ramsay goes one-on-one with Kyo Kusanagi to earn the right to face Monkey D. Luffy for the Cyberspace Championship at Unbound. Which superstar will emerge victorious and earn the title shot? We'll find out when the Elimination Chase concludes on episode 21. And ladies and gentlemen, I have just received word of this match that was just made by General Manager Phil Coulson. Earlier tonight, we saw Bebop defeat Captain Britain. Well, now it'll be their respective tag team partners' turn as Union Jack will face off against Rocksteady one-on-one on episode 21. Can Rocksteady keep the momentum going for his team heading into Unbound? Or can Union Jack find a way to shift the tide into his team's favor? We'll find out when these two clash on episode 21. Well, ladies and gentlemen, don't go anywhere. When we come back, it's main event time as Nathan Explosion teams with Light Yagami and Mad Max to face off against the team of Keith Abicari, William Wallace, and the UCWL champion, the Green Arrow. Six-man tag team action is next when UCWL returns.
ladies and gentlemen, this next contest is your main event of the evening, and is a six-man tag team match, and is set for one fall. Australian wastelands, he is the World Warrior, Mad Max!
And welcome back to episode 20, ladies and gentlemen, as we're now getting set for a six-man tag team match. This match was originally advertised as a tag team match, but after what happened at the beginning of our show between Mad Max and William Wallace, General Manager Phil Colson decided to add both of them into the mix, and now we got ourselves a six-man tag team match as Mad Max is now in the ring as we await his two tag team partners.
Osaka, Japan, White Yagami!
And as we just mentioned moments ago, ladies and gentlemen, General Manager Phil Colson made the match for Unbound. We will see White Yagami go one-on-one with Keith Abicari. Of course, White Yagami made his return at Cold Day in Hell, cost Keith Abicari his match to PS Power, and then went on to reasons to explain that he believes Keith Abicari is a waste of space and that he's the most talented member of the UCWL roster. Well, I'm not going to deny this man's talents, but he's definitely got an ego to go with it. And hopefully, Keith Abicari will put his ego in check when these two face off at Unbound, as we now await the final member of the first team in this match.
Tag team partner from Tampa, Florida, Nathan Explosion.
And here comes the final member of this team, Nathan Explosion, who we last saw at the end of our last episode, legitimately knocking out Yuri Boyka. As a result, Boyka's not here tonight. He's getting medically evaluated back in Hershey, Pennsylvania. Hopefully Boyka will be able to make it for the main event at Unbound, but right now, Nathan Explosion's ready to lead his team into battle in this six-man tag team match.
And their opponents, team number two, first from Woonsocket, Rhode Island, Keith Abicari.
And listen to this crowd as Keith Abicari is hyping them up for this huge six-man tag team match. Needless to say, Keith Abicari, he looks ready to go here. He cannot wait to get his hands on Light Yagami. As we now await Keith Abicari's two other tag team partners in this matchup.
Champions Tag Team Partner. From the Highlands of Scotland, he is the Braveheart, William Wallace.
It was all the way back on episode 17 that William Wallace got eliminated from the Elimination Chamber. Of course, that was courtesy of Mad Max's interference. And then afterwards, Mad Max brutally assaulted him. And then, of course, William Wallace made his return tonight and got into that huge brawl with Mad Max at the beginning of the show, which led to Phil Coulson putting him and Mad Max in this matchup. Needless to say, Wallace looks like he cannot wait to get his hands on Mad Max as we await their final tag team partner.
And their tag team partner, from Star City, he is the reigning UCWL champion, the Green Arrow!
And listen to this ovation for the reigning and defending UCWL champion, who will be putting his title on the line and Unbound in a triple threat match as he's set to face off against one of his opponents here tonight in this match. Needless to say, after what happened on the last episode, you could bet your ass that Green Arrow wants to get his hands on Nathan Explosion and send a message that he's ready to defend that title come their match at Unbound. And there's the bell, ladies and gentlemen, and we are underway with our main event here, as Keith Abicary is starting things off here against Mad Max. Hello, that's Mad Max. You gotta wonder if he even takes Keith Abicary seriously. Huge slam there from the Road Warrior. And a massive clubbing blow to the side of the head of Keith Abicary. And now, although that's no, Abicary back up. Sends Mad Max into the ropes. There's a back elbow there. Of course, Keith Abicary, very, very eccentric. Of course, now look at this. Tag is made. Here comes William Wallace. And a double back elbow. And it looks like we are back to where we started at the beginning of this episode. But between Mad Max and William Wallace. All right, let's know. Mad Max now backing out. Yeah, he does not want a piece of William Wallace now, does he? After all that trash talk that he did at the beginning of the show. As now Light Yagami's in the ring now with Wallace. And this huge forearm drop with that iron gauntlet he's got on his left arm. Gotta wonder if that hurts. And now William Wallace picking up Light Yagami. Big suplex there by the Braveheart. And of course, William Wallace, a lot of people were questioning whether or not he was still a part of the UCWL roster after he turned up at SCAW not too long ago. But now he's still a part of the roster. Although that's the Luthes press there by Light Yagami, taking down William Wallace. And there's a forearm drop of his own. Of course, like I mentioned before, I am not taking anything away from Light Yagami. He's a very talented individual in this ring, but he's got an ego just as big as his talents. Now look at this though. Wallace, nice takeover there. And now William Wallace makes the tag. Here comes the UCWL champion, the Green Arrow. Arrow now. Look at this. sending Yagami into the corner. Oh, look at this though. Yagami though fighting out of it. Well, at least trying to fight out of it. Into the ropes goes Yagami. Oh, this nice counter there. With a back suplex attempt there. Onto the Green Arrow. And, oh, here we go. Light Yagami has tagged in. Nathan Explosion. And you know the history between these two. Of course, Green Arrow became the UCWL champion on our pilot episode last summer by pinning Nathan Explosion in that gauntlet for the gold. And since then, Nathan Explosion has been a thorn in the Green Arrow side. Of course, who can forget their brutal UCWL title match back at Rise to Glory, our inaugural mega event. And of course, these two fought each other at the head-to-head special that UCWL had with the Destiny Championship Alliance not too long ago. And now these two will do battle again at Unbound. Of course, you're gonna at the X Factor of that match will be Yuri Boyka. We don't even know if Boyka's even medically cleared for that match after what transpired on our last episode. Look at this now, Green Arrow with a Falcon Arrow onto Nathan Explosion. Now look at this, the UCWL champion bringing Nathan Explosion to his feet, sending him into the corner. Oh wait, we've seen Arrow do this before! Springboard and Sagiri connects! And now, are we gonna see it? Oh, here we go! Queen's Gambit, he got it! The Queen's Gambit on a Nathan Explosion! And now this time Nathan kicks out. Now look at this now, Nathan Explosion back up. But walks right into a flatliner from the UCWL champion, and now Green Arrow makes the tag, and now Keith Abbott carries in. Now look at this, Nathan Explosion, huge shot to the back of the head of Keith Abbott carry, and Explosion follows it up with a side Russian leg sweep. And now Nathan Explosion tags Mad Max back in. Well, let's know Abakari inverted face buster there. Well, let's know Mad Max with a massive shot to the face there, and a huge wind up shot there from the Road Warrior. And now, look at this, though, Keith Abbott carry back in control. Snapmare fall by that fist drop. Now here's the cover by Abbott carry. Oh, how embarrassing would that have been for Mad Max to get pinned by Keith Abbott carry like that. Oh, wait, look at this. I was about to say Light Yagami going after Keith Abbott carry, but Mad Max stopped him. Now Mad Max tags in Nathan Explosion back in. And now Nathan Explosion sending Keith Abakari into the corner. This is not looking good for Abakari, as he's now hung in the tree of woe here. Well, that's Nathan Explosion going to work on Keith Abakari. Oh, here we go. And there's the hammer. The hammer by Nathan Explosion. And he normally follows it up. Are we going to see it? The Metalocalypse. Metalocalypse by Nathan Explosion. But look at this though, Abakari. Abakari's back up, trying to fight back here. But Nathan sends him into the corner. And again with the shinbreaker onto Keith Abakari. Now here's the cover by Nathan. And oh, look at that, only a one count. Now Nathan explosion. What's this? He's got Keith Avicari. No, Avicari blocks the suplex attempt and hits one of his own. Nice counter there by Keith Avicari. He may be very eccentric, but the guy can wrestle what he wants to. And now Avicari. Look at this. Running bulldog out of the corner. Here's the cover. Two and no. Only a two count. Avicari missing the knee to the back there. As Nathan Explosion hits a neck breaker. Look at this. Here's the cover. And only a one count. This match is starting to break down. Hopefully the referee can get control here. Oh, look at that. Missing the kick there. Avicari with a side Russian leg sweep. Well, is Avicari doing a moonwalk? Didn't even know he could do that. Avicari now. With Nathan Explosion. Oh, look at this. Big time suplex there from Keith Avicari. Oh, we're going to see a Keith Avicari! The Sega sign! The Sega sign on the Nathan Explosion! And no! Only a two count. What a victory that would have been right there for Keith Avicari. Avicari's on the top rope again. Oh, this time connects with a knee drop. The knee drop off the top rope connects. Tag is made. Here comes the UCWL champion, the Green Arrow, back in. Arrow goes for the cover. Two and no. Oh, man. What a match this is between these two teams here. Oh, let's say Nathan Explosion with the uppercut. But look at this, Green Arrow sending Nathan in the corner. And Nathan fights out of it with a DDT. And now Nathan, oh, here we go again. The hammer. The hammer onto the UCWL champion. Will this be it? Is Nathan Explosion going to get the pinfall here? Two and no. He's not. And now, oh, reversal there by Nathan into the reverse DDT. So far, a hell of a match between both these teams. Oh, look at that though. Mad Max, stun gun on the William Wallace. And now Max going after the Green Arrow. He does not care about his other teammates. Oh, wait a minute. And look at that, Nathan. Nathan Explosion with the Metalocalypse. The Metalocalypse under the Green Arrow. Is this going to be it right here? Two and no. I'm not sure if Green Arrow kicked out of that or did William Wallace break that up. There was so much action going on, I couldn't tell what was happening. Nathan Explosion now. Tag is made. Here comes Light Yagami back in. And now Yagami going to work on the UCWL champion. Oh, that's the Arrow sitting in the corner, but Yagami reverses it. Now placing Green Arrow on the top rope here. What does Light Yagami have planned here? Oh, it's the most overused move in all professional wrestling. The superplex. And now, Yagami makes the tag. Here comes Mad Max back in. And of course, Mad Max does have a history with the Green Arrow as well. Mad Max now on the second rope. Misses the forearm. Like we mentioned before, Mad Max has a history with the Green Arrow as well. Remember, Mad Max was the pick your poison opponent for the Green Arrow. That was all the way back on episode 6. Oh, look at that! Oh, what a super kick there from Green Arrow right into the face of the Road Warrior. And now, look at this. Oh, that dragon suplex to the bridge. And I'm not sure why William Wallace did that. William Wallace prevented Green Arrow from getting the pinfall there. I guess he wants to be the one to pin Mad Max. I don't know. Friendly fire, I guess. In any case, this match continues. Green Arrow now sending Mad Max into the corner. And now tag is made. William Wallace is in. A stab there followed by that running boot to the face there by the Braveheart. And now Wallace has his hands on Mad Max. Looks like Mad Max fighting out of the corner. Oh, William Wallace now. Oh no, counter there by Mad Max. And there's a spine buster. And now Mad Max could be setting up for it. There it is. We finally got a name for that move too. He calls it Fury Road. But unfortunately, Fury Road does not get him the victory. And look at this. Mad Max taunting the fans. Not exactly sure if that's a smart move. He did not consider he didn't win the match yet. Oh, what a right hand there by Mad Max. And now the tag is made. Here comes Light Yagami. Yagami now with Mad Max. Oh, look at this. Now going for the cover. And no, only a one count. It's going to take a lot more than that to put William Wallace down. And now, oh, that shot to the midsection. Oh, look at that. Angle slam there by Light Yagami. And now Yagami with a huge knee drop into the forehead of the Braveheart. This is not looking good now. Yagami on the second rope. Measuring William Wallace. Axe handle off the top rope, off the second rope connects. And now, picking him up. All right, oh, look at that. It's blocked. Uppercut there by Wallace. Oh, look at that kick to the face there by William Wallace. Atomic drop. And now, what's William Wallace going to do? He's picking him up. Nope. Yagami sweeps the legs. And now, what's he got planned here? Nope. Shot to the midsection there by Wallace. Kick is blocked. Now look at this. Wallace in a lot of trouble. The half Boston Crab. And look at that. Green Arrow able to easily break up the hold. Arrow now sending Yagami onto the ring apron. Yagami quickly back in. Oh, here's the cover from Yagami. Two and no. Now, Light Yagami seems to be getting pissed that he cannot put away William Wallace here. Shot to the midsection. Oh, wait! William Wallace with the Claymore. William Wallace hit the Claymore. Two. And he got him. Holy crap! William Wallace hit the Claymore out of nowhere and got the victory for his team here tonight. As we now take a look at the action that took place during this matchup. First, now it's one of the many pitfalls there. There you see Nathan Explosion hitting the hammer. But it was right here. Look at that. Nathan Explosion, William Wallace just hitting the Claymore out of nowhere onto Light Yagami, and that was it.
Here are your winners, the team of Keith Abigail, William Wallace, and the UCWL champion, the Green Arrow.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, that's all the time we have here today. We'll see you all for the final episode of UCWL before we head to Unbound. We'll see you next time.